Hey, welcome back to Apple Today. Today I've got a super quick tip on how to import an image sequence into AppleMotion and play back a very short animation, kind of like a flipbook. So I'm going to start by importing the individual frames into AppleMotion, and if you look at my screen, you can see that I've got 9 of them. I'm just going to do a quick view of these so you can see what they are. Just a little guy running. Nothing too fancy. And they're numbered 1 through 9, so I'm going to select them all. I'm going to drag them into Motion. They all import as individual elements in the timeline. And that's not what we want at all. So I'm going to undo that. So I'm going to go back to the Finder. And what needs to happen is that I need to rename these images using a format that AppleMotion understands. And I've actually already renamed them in this folder here. And you can see that I've added a .001, .002, etc. as a file name suffix just prior to the file name extension, just prior to the .png. And it's that first period here that's important. By the way, you can have more than 2 zeros preceding the number. You can have 3, 4, 5, I don't think it matters. So if you had a large image sequence, it wouldn't be an issue. So I'm going to select all these. So I'm going to drag these onto Motion, and if I hold for a second, you'll see that a menu appears, and we can either import stills, which is what we've already done, and we certainly don't want to do that again, or we can import the image sequence, which is what I'm going to do. And you can see that they imported successfully. If I hit the spacebar to play it, it plays the image sequence, although only one time. What I'm going to do is just quickly select the project and change the background color to make this a little bit easier to see. There we go. In order to play this image sequence indefinitely, we need to replicate it. So I'm going to select replicate up here. Now we got a whole bunch of them. Obviously, it's not what we want. The problem is the shape is set to rectangle up here in the top left. We need to change that to point so it only makes one. And there you have it. Our little guy is running forever in AppleMotion, and we can actually make him move across the screen pretty easily. I'm just going to reposition him to the left. Quickly add a throw behavior. And I only want him to move in the X velocity, so I'm going to adjust that to say 350 or around there. That's close enough. And as you can see, he zips across the screen. And that's it. I hope this was helpful. Thanks so much for watching. I'm John Martins. Please subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Apple a Day.